The NHL trade deadline is a time for fans to look at all the trades that transpired and evaluate them. But for every trade that gets completed, there are multiple trades that never see the light of day. So, in the spirit of the deadline, let's take a look at some of the best deals that never happened. Starting off, Steven Stamkos is one of the staples of the dominant Tampa Bay Lightning. But after a rookie season where he struggled, the co-owner of the Lightning, Len Barry, had agreed to deal the young forward to the New York Rangers in 2009. The package would have included the GM's choice of three of Evgeny Grachev, Brandon Dubinsky, Dan Girardi, Ryan Callahan, and Michael Delzato. All that was left for the GM and the other part owner was to agree to the deal, which, as we can see today, never happened. Next, Tyler Seguin, as we all know, saw his tenure in Boston end after a trade to Dallas. But when Boston had decided that Seguin wasn't involved in their plans for the future, another deal almost went through. Wanting to go for another cup run, the Bruins approached the Buffalo Sabres looking to acquire Thomas Vanek and another player off their roster. But in the summer of 2013, the Sabres thought that this was too much and walked away from the deal. All I can say is that Seguin would look pretty good in Sabres blue. Moving on, we all know about PK Subban and the perpetual trade talks he faced in Montreal. Most notable was a potential deal to Edmonton. But just 2 years earlier, in 2014, there was the chance that Subban could have been a Philadelphia Flyer. The initial offer from Philly was Sam Moran, a 2015 first-round pick, and apparently an important roster player. The Flyers eventually backed away from this deal, and we know the rest of that story. But now moving on to the only trade that only involved picks. At the 2012 draft, Garth Snow and the New York Islanders were desperate for a top-quality D-man, and they had identified Ryan Murray as their guy. The only problem was that the Islanders picked 4th, and Murray would have been gone at pick 2. But being so desperate for Murray, they had offered Edmonton every single one of their picks in the 2012 draft for the first overall pick. So the trade would have probably looked like the first pick for the 4th, 34th, 65th, 103rd, 125th, 155th, and 185th picks. The Oilers, though, they instead decided to take Yakupov with the first overall pick instead of that giant offer. And the final trade on this list involves the great one, Wayne Gretzky. We know how his trade to LA was massive for the time, but he almost got traded to Vancouver. In 1988, Edmonton had asked the Canucks for 5 first-round picks and $22 million in cash for Gretzky. Back then, that was a lot of money to give up. So the Canucks declined, and Gretzky was moved to LA instead. So what kind of almost deals will the next few trade deadlines and draft days bring us? Well, we're gonna have to wait and see, but it's sure to make a number of fan bases cringe at what could have been. I hope you liked the video, and I'll see you in the next one.